Welcome to the next video in custom theme development with WordPress. In this particular lesson, we will be talking about how we can export a website from WordPress so that we can import the content into another site. We're going to be learning how to do this without the use of a plugin. We're just going to be using WordPress. Previously, we looked at how we could use some plugins to create a backup of our website. Now, what I'm going to be able to show you is how you can create an export of your file, and you'll be able to manually create your own XML file. This has its own set of nuances, which we will talk about within this lecture. By the end of this demonstration, you will be able to export your WordPress website without using any plugins. This will include all of your posts, pages, comments, and navigation. You'll be able to do this by generating an XML file that you can then use to import into another WordPress website. Reasons why you might want to export and import a website in this way is potentially you might want to migrate your site. You may want to move the content from one WordPress site to another because you're changing domains or hosts. You also might want to create a backup. You may want to save a copy of your posts, pages, and media for safety or archiving. Another reason might be a site design or rebuild. You may need to transfer content to a clean or redesigned WordPress install without bringing over old themes or plugins. In addition, you can split or merge sites, so you could combine multiple sites into one or split one site's content into multiple WordPress installs. And you can use this for testing or staging. You may want to copy content to a staging site for testing changes without affecting the live site. So let's go ahead and jump into WordPress and see how this works. For this particular demonstration, I'm going to be using this site. This site isn't extensively built out. The main thing that I'm interested in bringing into my new website are my pages and posts. You can see that I have unique content on all of my pages and all of my posts. The posts include images along with content, and what I would like to do is transfer this information into a new clean install. I will ultimately be bringing this information into this version of WordPress, and as you can see, I don't have any content aside from the default content that WordPress has installed. I've already gone ahead and selected the existing posts and deleted them, as well as the existing pages. So if I refresh the site, I actually don't have any content at all inside of this new theme. The only thing I have done in this theme is I went ahead and created a new user. I'm going to be using this user so that I can demonstrate how this process will work. We'll get started by working in the site that we want to export the content from. I'll start off by going to Tools, Export, and from here is where you can specify what you want to export. If we select All Content, it will export posts, pages, comments, terms, and navigation menus. You could specify that you just want to export certain content, such as posts or pages, or even media, although media is a little bit challenging, and I'll show you how this works. I will just simply select all content. I'll select download export file, and WordPress is going to go ahead and create an XML file for me. If I navigate to my hard drive where my downloads are saved, you will see that I now have a new file with the XML extension. This contains all of the content that I want to import. And just to show you this, I'm just going to drag this to the browser. The XML file is going to display as a code-based file. And based on what we learned in our last exercise, you may start recognizing some of the XML-based content. I do want to draw your attention to an area in the website where I'm using some sort of image. So right here is an image. And as you can see, the URL is based on the location of the image. So in this case, I've developed my site locally, and the image exists in my local version of the website. It also is telling me where the image exists inside of WordPress. WordPress stores images in the WP Content Uploads folder. If I go into the site and go into App, Public, WP Content, there will be an Uploads folder, and this is going to contain a folder with the year. This is currently the site that I just created. 05 stands for the month. I'm currently in the month of May. And as you can see, no images exist. If I, however, open my original theme, if I open my original website, so this is the website that contains all of the content, and if I navigate into WP Content Uploads 2025, you'll see that this particular website has two subfolders. 04 is all of the content that was imported in the month of April, and 05 is the month of May, which currently is empty. These images inside 04 are all the images that I'm using on my website. So this is where all the media exists within the website. So basically, this is the folder that contains all of the content for our website. I just wanted to point this out so that you know where WordPress stores the media files. Let's return to our brand new theme that currently doesn't contain any content. I will go to Tools, and I'm going to go to Import. Now that I have the XM file, I'm ready to import the content into this new, fresh install of WordPress. Once you go to Tools, you're going to go to WordPress Install Now. This is going to go ahead and install the WordPress importer. You will have the option to run the importer, which is the same thing as activating the plugin and starting the importer process. I'll go ahead and do this now. Once you do this, you're going to be prompted to upload the XML file. So I'm going to simply navigate and choose my XML file. Here is the file that we just created. I'll click Open, and then I'm going to click Upload File and Import. In the next window, you're going to be prompted to assign authors for all of your posts and pages. You will need to choose an existing user of your new website. So as I mentioned, I had created a new user called Zeb, and then of course I am the admin user. I'm going to assign all of my posts to Zeb. My import author was Emily, but I'm going to change this to Zeb just to show you how this works. You can also create a brand new user or login, and if you do this, it's going to take you to another window. As you can see, we do have an option to download and import file attachments. In theory, this sounds like a great option. I'm going to go ahead and select it, but it doesn't always work in the way that we want it to work. So I'll show you what happens once I import the content. I'll go ahead and click Submit, and as you can see, it already is failing to import many of my media-based content. If, however, we go into our posts, you're going to see that I have all of the posts that were originally created in my original website. The author has been assigned to Zeb, and the categories came directly from the original website. If we go to pages, you'll also see that I have the same pages that were created in the original site. The author, again, is assigned as Zeb. If we go to our media file, you will see that no media items are found. If we check the front end portion of WordPress and refresh, you will see that my pages exist and my content is showing up, all of the text-based content, but none of my pictures are going to show up. The reason the images are not showing up is because the actual image files are not embedded inside of the XML file. And as I mentioned, this is the URL. Notice that the link to the URL is an absolute path. It is showing me where the original image was located. The only way in which your images would appear in your new site is if they're being hosted and they remain hosted on the internet. If I had made a copy of this website and it was hosted on the internet, and for whatever reason I left it on the internet, these images would then have an absolute path that pertained to the domain and they would show up inside of my new website. However, because I'm using a local copy, this path is no longer correct. It doesn't exist. So what we can do is we can manually move the images. I'm going to go back to my Finder. I'm going to select all of the images inside of this 04 folder, and I will create a copy and place them or copy them into my 05 folder. Now they exist in my 05 folder. They still aren't going to show up on our website because, again, the path is no longer correct. If we go to the media library and we do a hard refresh, they don't show up in the media library either. The reason that they don't show up is because after manually uploading, WordPress doesn't automatically add the images to the media library. We know that they are present and they're in the correct folder, but they're not going to show up in the dashboard. So what we need to do is we're going to need to use a plugin. I'll go ahead and do that now. I'm going to go to plugins. And as you can see, the only plugin I have is the WordPress importer. This was installed when we did our tools import. At this point, I don't need this, so I'm simply going to deactivate that. We need to force WordPress to rescan for new files that are in our WP Content Uploads folder. We're going to use a plugin to do this. We'll be using the free plugin called Media Sync. And if you search for Media Sync, you're going to find this plugin right here. I'm going to install and activate this plugin. Now that you've activated the Media Sync plugin, you're going to go to Media, and you'll see that we have a new subcategory called Media Sync. I'm going to click this, and this is the location where I can sync up the uploads. We are going to want to go to Sync Files. When you come to this page, you will see that you have the option to do a rescan. Rescan refreshes the file list by rechecking the WP Content Upload folder for any new media files that are not yet registered in the WordPress Media Library. It's going to scan through the upload folder and compare what's physically on the server and what's already in the Media Library database. What we need to actually do to start is we need to import the selected items. So we're going to click Import Selected. However, it is worth mentioning that this dry run checkbox is checked by default. If this is checked, it simulates the import process without making any actual changes to your website. So what it's going to do is it's going to scan the list of files that would be imported. So if we try to run the import and we click on our 2025 and select the images, here they all are inside our 05 folder, and I click Import Selected, it's going to look like the images were successfully imported. And it lets me know, hey, the highlighted files were successfully imported, rescan to see changes. So I'm going to click Rescan. And if we go to Library, you're not going to see any changes. That's because we were in the dry run area. So we want to actually update our database. I'm going to uncheck this. Once again, I'm going to select the files that I want to import, and then we're going to go ahead and import selected. It's going to run through the process. This may take a little bit longer because it is making changes to the database. Now that that is completed, I'm going to click rescan. And if we go to the library, you will now see all of the images are going to appear inside of the WordPress Media Library. At this point, if I come to the front end portion of my website and I refresh, the images still do not show up here. We're going to have to manually fix the images. Sometimes this process will work and the images will show up, but it doesn't always work. It's a little tricky with the images. Keep in mind, if you are doing this more manual method of updating your WordPress website, there's a good possibility that the images are not going to transfer over. I have showed you in previous lectures how we can use various plugins that will allow us to go ahead and include images with the backup, but this manual method doesn't do a great job with images. However, it does do a good job with the page content. The other thing that I want to draw your attention to is if we go to the blog or to the recipe page, those are empty. And here is my recipe page right here. So why didn't the recipes come over? Well, this has to do with the fact that this page, we had originally created a query loop, and the query loop is no longer working in the same way. So if I click on query loop, you're going to see that in my new website, the category is plant-based bowls. If I go to my original website and I go to the page and I'm on recipes right now, if we select our query loop, you're going to see that the category is set to recipe. So for whatever reason, the categories don't always transfer over in the query loop. So I'm simply going to get rid of this. And as soon as I do that, this is now showing, but I only want to show recipes. At this point, it's going to show all of my posts, and I have not updated all of my featured images, which is why they don't exist. But there are some posts that aren't using the category of recipe, and they are now showing up. So I will switch this to my recipe category. And if we save this page now and go back to the front end part of WordPress, then refresh, you're going to see that my recipe posts are now going to appear within this particular area. The other thing that I want to draw your attention to is if we go to the blog page is currently empty. And if we check the blog page in the back end, this is the new version of our website, you can see that the blog page is based off of the template pages. If I go to the original website and I go to the blog page is based off of the template blog home. The reason that this is different is because in the original website, under settings, under reading, I had set the homepage to be home and the post page to be blog. In our new version of WordPress, if I go to settings, reading, those things have not been specified. I'll simply select a static page and we'll assign the home page to go to home and the post page to go to blog. We'll save the changes. And now if we refresh our blog page, it is going to show the blog post. So in this case, the images are showing up. And the reason that they're showing up is because these two posts are the ones where I set the featured image. But if we scroll down to the posts where I have not yet set up my featured images, they do not show up. So I did want to point these things out to you. Images can be a little tricky. There are some settings that will not update, such as the name of the theme. You can see here it was assigned as green.blue. Here it's simply showing as custom theme 3. Again, this is a setting area. So right here, custom theme 3, I would need to update this to whatever I want the new site to be. And I could create a tagline and I can also choose a site icon. I have my icons uploaded, so I could select the correct site icon. And if we save these new settings, they're gonna now update. If I refresh my front end, you'll see I get my little site icon. Now the correct name is showing. And then I would need to do other things like organize my menu into the proper order. When you do this, if you're using this more manual method, you will want to double check the site and make sure that everything is appearing in the correct order. You might need to make some modifications in the back end. The important part, though, is that all of our text-based content did come in. All of the headers, paragraphs, lists, all of those sorts of things did come right in. It's just the images and stuff like that might be a little off and might need a little bit of massaging. I did want to teach you how to do this, however, because sometimes you might want to just grab your text-based content. In this case, I did have a bunch of content that I had previously created, and I just wanted to leverage having that content in my new website so that I could begin to work on it and make modifications.